a cross wrist. He cannot do one thing until he breaks that cross wrist. And guys, my guys used to be terrible at breaking a cross wrist. Here's what I see a lot of high school guys do. Bryce is gonna break me down. He's on tight waist chop. Bryce is gonna fall to his hip. I'm gonna fall to my hip. And he's gonna come right here to a cross wrist. I see this all the time. Watch how most people react. Here's how most people react in my shoes. So Bryce is on top. He tight waist chops. He falls to his hip. I fall to my hip. He's got the cross wrist right there. Can you guys see that? And here's what most people do in Jeff Jordan's shoes. They do the dumbest thing in the world. They take their knees away and they come back. They land right here. And then they try to play this little game where they reach their hand and try to unlock, to try to break that grip that he's got, or try to break the cross wrist. So all I'm saying, guys, I never want to go to my stomach, or he's going to ride me forever. Again, he tight waist chops. When I hit here, here's what everyone does. They take their knees away, and they say, I got to base out. When I do that, I promise you, Bryce is going to ride me for a long time. All I'm asking is, first thing you got to do, as soon as he gets that cross wrist, we have to break it. And the only way to break it, Bryce, the only way to break this cross wrist when he has it is I extend my left hand down. Just create a little bit of space, and then my right elbow comes in. And then, guys, I shove down, I rip up here. And then, guys, hand way out, elbow in. And, guys, I'm not kidding you. We get a lot of inside leg stand-ups from here. Watch what's going to happen. Once he breaks me down across wrist, I do not break me down. I do not stop from right here. The last thing in the world I'm going to do is to go down there. Right when we hit, look at my bottom foot. I extend this hand, elbow comes in, I rip it off here. And then, guys, my left hand goes big time that direction. You know what he's going to do, guys? He's got the tight waist. I always do this. I take my right knee and I try to kick myself in the face. He's going to follow, all right, otherwise I'll just head Gramby out. He's going to follow, and watch how I stand up with this leg. Right knee kicks myself right in the face. I do this right here. As he covers, he drives in, drive in, drive in. It brings me to my feet, and then I cut. I'm not kidding. 1 or 2 years, guys, I mean, we drill this every year. Because if a guy gets a cross wrist, guys, you got to watch the Easton tilt, you got to watch the arm bar. Cross tilt, you gotta watch what I call a sugar bowl or the ball and chain. The first thing I have to do is to break this wrist. Again, he's here, he tight waist chops, he goes to his hip, I hit my hip, I don't stop here. Instantly extend my hand, break it. I don't leave my hand here, guys, because then when I go to kick myself in the face, he's gonna come right back and grab that wrist. So once I break it, hand exaggerated that direction. Right knee tries to kick myself in the face. He covers, he drives in. Every time it's going to bring me up to an inside leg stand up. Does that make sense, guys? I think a lot of guys get cross-wristed, and I see them always laying right there on their stomach. I'm just telling you to break it. Let's try it real quick. Let's go.